Hi Sid, welcome to Chrome Talkies.
Hey, thanks. Thanks so
How much. Does it feel to be on the different side of the table?
It's always tough. I've done this a few times and I wouldn't probably do it had you not asked me.
So tell me, why one more business news channel?
Well, we have a long history. This channel was actually started as UTV News and
it was actually UTVI. I was part of the founding team of UTVI.
So there you have
what
it.
What a small world.
So it's a long history, and 2 years back we came up with a new homegrown brand called Business Television India, and I'm happy to tell you, I think it just sort of came out of several ideation sessions. And Business Television India, according to us, was the closest that we could be to the genre and the need that we are trying to serve, which is bring business news to Indian viewers and make it simple, keep it smart and sophisticated, but not 30,000 feet above your head.
Yes, very well said. So, Sid, you've got a career spanning almost two decades, or over two decades, and between television and print, right? What is it, television or print?
50-50.
What's more fun, television or print? I've been on both sides.
Exactly.
So, I think I'm inherently a television guy.
Yeah, so 10 years back, I would have said, wow, you know, print. 20 years now with equal time spent in television, I would say, look at the next 20.
Right.
And I would say that it's going to be a hybrid. I think what technology has done for us is that it is bringing print and TV together.
Right.
You therefore, as a journalist,
right,
need to have all skill sets. It's no longer about having one skill set.
Right.
That doesn't work.
Right.
Multi-skilling is the basic eligibility norm.
Absolutely.
That I would say for our industry.
Absolutely. And as you see the industry evolving, as you see technology evolving, everything that is audio-visual in nature is probably easier to consume because you target both the senses, audio and video, and that probably could be a reason why if you look at the absolute shares of television versus print, you see television, and within television now you've got OTT and linear collectively eating out of the share of only a audio or only a visual medium.
Absolutely.
Right?
I think you said it right. What really is happening, according to me, is that all of us are evolving to serve the needs of a customer basis feedback. You know, the feedback that existed in print used to be a loop of 7 to 10 days where someone would write you a letter.
Right.
And then you would decide whether to respond to it or not.
Right.
In television, that response time got shortened. And on with online platforms and messaging platforms and Twitter, that feedback is instant. So I think what is really happening, Pankaj, for the benefit of our viewers, I would say that what you call linear TV will continue to have its place as long as it is a specialized, a specialized coverage of live events. So the stock markets, which currently are open from 9 a.m. till 3:30 p.m. and there is in fact talk that those hours could be extended.
Right.
So business television.
I was part of that show. We were on the other side of the table on the extension of the hours.
Exactly. So as long as we continue to do a good job in covering live news, broad television, big screen television will have its place.
Right.
I think for other needs, there will be what you would call non-linear TV. It could be sort of smaller edited capsules being put out on various platforms, being distributed on various digital platforms, OTT platforms.
Sure.
But the core need of interpreting and relaying stock market developments within India and from overseas, in fact, will continue to be done by business television. So I would argue one last point, that in fact, the challenge for us is to be more 24-hour than be less 24-hour. And I'll tell you what I mean by that. If we spend 8 to 10 hours of doing live coverage, I would ideally want it to be 20 hours. Why do I need a foreign setup to tell me about the American markets?
Right. Why can't you do it in-house?
Why can't I do it in-house?
So the daytime it's Indian, the nighttime it's US.
And from India, because, you know, just as an aside, If you go to any financial capital, go to any large financial company, and you'll see dozens and dozens of people from India who work there. So my point is that why do we have to wait for a foreign beam to come into India and tell us what is happening in the global market?
Absolutely.
Crude oil, for example, it's a huge thing,
right.
Very significant. Why should I not have a Saudi Arabia correspondent?
Right.
So it's a function of costs.
Right.
Most certainly it is.
Right.
But I would say that the future for business television,
right.
business information,
right.
for saving, for investing, for prospering,
right.
in a country of 1.2 billion people is immense. I don't think we are a shrinking market like Europe or the
right.
United States.
Right.
So I think this belief that, oh well, audiences are slipping away is a bit overstated in the
right.
Indian context.
Right.
In India.
Right.
Multi-platforms will exist for far longer
right.
than in the US and Europe. So Pankaj, I would say that we need to have an Indian view of analyzing the data, and that's why I take great pride in sitting with you and chatting
I
about
I take
that
equal
matter.
Pride in chatting up with you, Sid. That brings me to my next question, Sid. What we see today, the line between business and politics is constantly blurring, right? So when it's business TV, right, are you also carrying a lot of political content, or are you consciously trying to limit yourself to business, or it's fluid as the news demands?
I think it's more of a response of news developments, as you said. But as strategy, what I can say is purely the data tells us, Pankaj, and you know that our audiences in India are extremely sophisticated. For the business audience, what is important to know and to sort of be relevant to is major policy developments.
Right.
So let me give you an example. If India is going to go out and talk to the Gulf countries and say, listen, I don't want to pay in rupees to buy oil. I import 90% more of my crude oil. I want you to come up with a mechanism where I don't have to pay you dollars all the time. Let's try and figure out some sort of barter or
right.
a system. That is extremely significant news. It's also significant when the government decides to tell oil marketing companies, drop 1 rupee from your profits, and we saw how oil stocks got completely hammered.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So for business television, policy and political decisions which have an impact on companies and their earning and their performance and
right.
the general economy, that is what is relevant. Will pure politics be important? Of course it will be. And for example, you would have noticed that we've just recently launched a new show, Rajneeti, where it's basically on the intersection of policy and politics, and
right.
And we believe that as we go into election season full time,
right.
our political news, pure political news offering will expand to be
right.
in conformity with what our viewer really demands. And I think
right.
we are going to invest significantly, and you will see more news coming out from BTVI on that front, Pankaj.
Right, that is very interesting. We have a lot of, we did an analysis of the viewers who've been watching Chrome Talkies. We have a decent chunk of students watching Talkies. So the question goes for them, what is it to be an anchor, right? And a lot of these kids believe the great thing about being an anchor is you become famous. Right.
Well,
so, what's so good about being an anchor? Is it a good thing to be an anchor?
I don't know. I think it's a profession. It's certainly got a element of glamour and recognition, wider recognition associated with it. It's not a backroom job.
Right.
But you know, first things.
But
first,
a lot of hard work goes right. You can't walk into a show with no preparation.
Absolutely.
Right? Your knowledge levels have to be at peak.
You
get challenged by the experts.
You hit it on the head, really. But I just want to say one thing before I sort of try and describe what it means to be an anchor. I think in television, as you know, Pankaj, there are more people behind the camera
right.
than in front. And I think every day when I wake up and I remember to tell myself that those are the guys who are actually doing all the hard work.
Right.
So an anchor's life is far more cushier in comparison. But what does it need to be an anchor? I think a business anchor actually has to be an extremely knowledgeable, hard-working person.
Right.
Just like big investors tell you, people who invest and manage people's money and invest it in the market, they tell you that 70% of their time is spent in reading, in doing plain reading, newer concepts, reading right. about companies, economic development. Similarly, an anchor has to have an extreme ability to absorb information and process right. it. And then, of course, you need to have the skills to sort of be able to talk,
right.
to be able to sit in front of a camera, and most right. important, and this is the last point, although the there could be a dozen points that we could right. discuss, Pankaj, is empathy.
That's
the ability
so important.
To listen, the ability so to important. Understand. And,
and that's how you interact. That's how you have a two-way communication.
Absolutely. And I think business anchors, especially in a country like India, where a lot more people are trying out equity investment for the first time and moving away from the mindset of, you know, is it good to only remain invested in fixed deposits
right.
or should we take the risk of investing in equities? Now, equity investment
right.
is risky, there's no doubt about it.
Right.
So business anchors in India who are in some ways intermediating between an investor and between the products
yeah.
In which they are looking. I think we are just intermediaries, we are not advisors,
right.
regulations don't permit us to be there, but we have an immense responsibility of being truthful at all times.
That is so
I
important.
I don't think ideology,
that's
which
so
you
important.
See manifest in general news at times, where a channel
it's all
or
about
an
being
anchor
the first to
takes,
break
a,
the news.
Takes a certain stance and says, hey, why isn't this happening? I think for business, we have to be responsible to the point that we have to remember at all times, 24/7, 365 days a year, that people are putting in their hard-earned money, and therefore we have to be extremely accurate and truthful at all times.
Absolutely. That is so, so important. That brings me to my last question. When it comes to capturing viewers, today the trend is a lot of English channels are airing Hindi content. I'll give you an example. So if you go to English news, you have a decent chunk of English news channels, they have a dedicated Hindi hour. And I'll tell you why that happens, is because if the viewership of English is 0.5%, Hindi goes to almost 5%, which is almost 100 times more, right? So would BTVI, would you do that? Would you spend like an hour or 2 hours talking in Hindi, or would you air a show which is in English, jisme Hindi bhi hai, and you speak in English as well, and you broad base your opinion, your audiences almost 100-fold.
Okay,
you,
so
and if you're not doing that, you can thank me for giving you the idea to do that.
Well, you've done that before, and I'm happy to tell you that Rajneeti, which incidentally I anchor, is at times a English show. We respond to our viewers' demands, but we have. Like all English channels, there are certain internal restrictions in the way. It will need a different software, it will need a different sort of philosophy of trying to be fully bilingual at all times. And I have a question, Pankaj, and which I try and... if we were to do Hindi, why not do Gujarati? Why not do Telugu? Why not do Marathi? Why not
right.
do Kashmiri?
So you complete that answer, to give you a cue, Hindi is something that broad bases across the country, whereas going to Gujarati and regional feeds is more specific to a certain segment, right?
I think the way our industry has grown is that, especially with a lot of sort of media promoters looking at the network effect and having a flanking strategy, they all decided to set up different language-based
right.
Channels. I think it's a unique feature.
Right.
The Indian market is completely unique, unlike any other market in
right.
the country, in the world. I
right.
don't know of any other market where there are so many multiple language offerings. So final point really on that, will English work? Most certainly, yes. Does it always serve the interests of viewers? I'm not so sure, because if a viewer has come in and he expects a certain way of communication,
right.
That won't change. And I honestly also feel that as far as business television is concerned, the screens are mostly on mute.
Right.
Advertisers should know this. They
Absolutely.
Perhaps know this.
Absolutely.
And therefore, the screen speaks to you in one language. And that language is the Roman alphabet,
right.
especially when it comes to numbers.
Right.
Now, can I make the switch from Roman numericals to Devanagari numericals? to a Dravidian script.
You can geo-target that, right? By market, you can have multiple
script.
Feeds.
Can I go to Arabic numerical?
Programmatic TV, you can do that throughout. Absolutely.
I would love to do that.
You can do that.
I would love to do that. I think that's the next frontier
right.
to broad base, because you're absolutely right,
right
that as far as the English audience is concerned,
right.
The advertisers believe that it is at the top of the apex. I have a different view.
Right.
But if a product has to broad base and deepen right. its roots,
right.
at some point of time, that is
right.
the
so
way we need to go.
Right. So you have an option for what you said. Whether you could split supers during the show, right? That is a little away. But what you can do today is every time you go into a break, you can geotag basis different markets. You can actually dissect it to every single cable operator in the country. So the ideal thing for you to do is every time you go into a break, since you're running only 3 minutes of advertising time, spend 2 minutes on content which is very viewer friendly. So you have an opening and a closing, which is before an ad, the break bumper, right? And you target that for different markets. So for a Gujarati market, you have a cue when you go into a break, which is in Gujarati. Try that and you might see a number going up for you, right?
Viewers, that is Pankaj telling you about what next generation television in India will be. And I'm sure he has a plan.
See, the tables have turned. The tables have turned.
I'm sure he has a plan up there. So, Pankaj, I want to ask you a question.
Right.
Are you going to do this? Is there an investment opportunity for people to take a 2%, 5%, 10% stake in that unannounced venture of yours? Because I see it clearly.
It is completely.
It's all in your mind.
You use the right term. The venture is unannounced. Even I haven't heard of it.
Okay.
Right?
We'll sit down once again to see where.
Brilliant. It is. I want to take you there. I want to walk you through some numbers that we worked for you guys out.
Wonderful.
Right? And we'll have a scan on the big screen. And I'd like to have your inputs on the strategies, on advertising on advertising time, on television, on breaks, on various program formats, and how your ratings are faring at this point in time. So we'll walk you through the screen.
Yes, let's do that.
Yeah, let's go. Yeah. Okay, I'll quickly walk you through some very interesting data that we picked up for you guys. And let me begin by congratulating you for
Thank you so much.
Today, as far as the availability of BTVI is concerned in India, you are pretty much amongst the leaders. So there are four, and the availability is pretty much right now at almost 60%, up from almost 45 when you started out about a year ago. So you invested a lot of money in distribution. Huh?
Yes, we have.
You have?
We're trying.
Right, so I'll walk you through how the data works. Broadly, to get the ratings, right, it's a function of three things on air, which is the content that you work on, which you are in charge of, how you play around with breaks. I'm going to walk you on some data on breaks, on break pattern optimization, and on-air presentation and planning. Off-air is basically what happens on distribution and marketing. As we started off with the fact that on distribution over the last few months, you've invested hugely. And the number of people watching you, which is the reach, is also gone up, right?
Yep.
But there remains a gap on time spent per viewer. And I'll just walk you through on where the gaps are, and let's see if you're working towards that. And collectively, time spent per viewer and reach together bring you your viewerships and channel shares.
Yes.
Right. So let's see where we are on BTVI at this point in time. The market leader clearly remains ET now. They've been in business for a while, but you're not far behind. At 0.45% share, it's as good as a number two. Right. So how do you guys achieve that number? So that's a good growth, and you're already ahead of NDTV, right? Pretty much double. So that's been a good growth.
Single word answer, content.
Good content, right? You're in charge of content. Brilliant. So if you look at the time spent, I think what you've said is right, Sid, because the time spent is also at about 12 minutes. So there's no radical difference between 12 and 14 minutes. CNBC is got obviously the strongest stickiness at this point in time, but ET and BTVI remain pretty much close number two. Overall channel shares is where we have a gap, which is almost at 16%. I've asked the team to do some research on where the gaps are. My question to you, Sid, the first question, when it comes to business news, the priority markets are Mumbai at almost 60%, followed with Delhi and Bangalore. And these are in sync with the advertisers based in these markets, right? So are you also prioritizing your market for Delhi, Mumbai and Bangalore?
Well, clearly from a business content perspective, Pankaj, business content is national. In fact, it is international. There is very little local sort of content that is available in business, right? Because the markets are accessible to everyone.
Right.
Whether it's a retail investor or an institutional investor, you could be sitting in a different time zone 12 hours away and still punch an order into the Indian market. I think this is more of a traditional sort of the way our industry has grown. And remember, business television in India is 20 years old. We are, of course, just 2 years old. And that's why perhaps the channel share will go up as time goes up. What I really think about this data point that you've shown is it's going to change very, very rapidly. As our economy grows, as we move out of the tier one cities into tier two and tier three, and with the availability of online ability to invest in equities in debt, and the greater sort of financialization of products post demonetization, also the fact that you know there's more acceptance for online as a genre for doing anything, whether you do e-commerce, and it's pretty much as easy to buy a product off an e-commerce site as you could buy a set of shares. Right. So this is going to change. Right. This is the past.
Sorry to cut you. This is from a viewership point of view. You will have data as far as trading is concerned. Is that also skewed towards these metros? Or is that uniform across the country?
That data doesn't reside with us. It resides with the exchanges and platforms.
Right.
But remember, the days of physical exchanges are long gone and over. I think everyone sits behind a terminal. You could be driving and doing this. So I don't know the layer to that data point that you are asking, but is this a proxy for that? I certainly don't think so. I think there's a difference. Maybe it also reflects some amount of spare capital. It's also about attitudes. We know that investing is an attitude, saving is an attitude.
Right.
And perhaps there is a proxy that you see in the more developed states of Maharashtra, Gujarat, versus other states which in the economic sort of ranking are far lower.
Right. Taking a cue from what you said, could this also be a function of broadband connectivity, how well it's connected?
I think that's going to change. Yeah. It's already showing some amount of traction. The availability of online platforms where you can do equity transactions, that's number one.
Right.
Mutual funds, again, because mutual funds are dominating our markets and a lot of money is getting invested through mutual funds rather than direct equity, those fund and institutions perhaps have offices in Mumbai. So there is no geographical sort of spread as far as investment is concerned.
Right.
You give your money to a mutual fund and that goes ahead and decides to invest in a certain group of stocks.
Right.
So all that I want to say at this stage is that this, as far as the viewership contribution is concerned, is history, is the past, and the past, as we know, recedes every second.
Right.
I think the point that you have asked is with the availability of greater ease of bandwidth, lower cost bandwidth, this is going to completely change. And in the digital world, what will matter is the exact sort of IP address which logged on, rather than
and
a
you can track
sitting
everything
in front of a TV somewhere.
Brilliant. Absolutely. I think so. This is the past, as you rightly said. Moving on to the present, we found something very interesting. If you were to look at the trading hours, and we were to dissect the commercial time, the time spent on taking breaks, BTVI spends practically almost just 3 minutes in an hour on breaks vis-a-vis rest of the competition. So my question to you, Sid, is that a deliberate effort or you don't have advertisers?
No, I don't think it's linked to advertising. I think the amount of content that is given out in every hour is a function of the availability of that content, the ability of the teams to put out that content and keep refreshing it.
Right. So let me ask you, so one thing very interesting, are you deliberately limiting your advertising to only 3 minutes per hour, or you don't have advertisers.
Well, you know, I think the best way to answer that question is that obviously if there would be greater inventory that is demanded, that there is of course that ability to do it. But remember, there's a regulatory.
Be candid. You wouldn't know about the advertising. Are you involved in the advertising process?
No, no, no.
I'm not.
Is there
a deliberate mandate from editorial to limit the advertising?
No, there is no such mandate. But remember, there is a regulatory cap on the per minute advertising.
Yeah,
that
but
you
that
can
is,
offer.
This is well below because the regulatory cap is 10+2. So
sure,
you see
sure.
now also
sure,
they're
sure.
all at par. They're all within within
so,
the domain.
So I think it's a function of business. It's a but if you ask me, is there a situation where we say no to advertisers? Most
sure.
certainly not.
But let me tell you, this is working for you because the fact is every time you go into a break, there is an audience drop of almost 25% to 40%. And the longer the break, the more the drop. So for a channel which is building time spent, I think if it's a deliberate strategy, it is a good strategy.
Okay.
Right?
I,
but it, comes, it costs a lot of money.
I leave that expert comment to you.
But at least it costs you a lot of money to do that, right? So now coming out to something very interesting that we found out, and what we've tried to do, Sid, is we've tried to compare how do you get viewers for news versus business news. What is it that impacts TVRs or rating points, or what the masses know as TRPs? How does that get impacted, right? So for news, it is mostly a function of anchor affinity, right? How strong is the anchor? How well known is an anchor? Vis-a-vis business news, which is more a function of the stories covered.
Yep.
So my question to you, Sid, are you investing a lot on getting the right stories at the right time? And I'll tell you, I've been part of the GST and the demonetization drives. The numbers seem to have worked for you. So are you consciously focusing more on stories vis-a-vis anchor investments?
Absolutely. And I think you touched upon a very, very important point. And I'll just like to illustrate. The markets are all about money. They're about strategic investment decisions, and business channels, regardless of their name,
right,
in India or the language, and we also have a very healthy market.
Right.
We have two leading Hindi news channels, we have a Gujarati offering, we have three English channels, we have a fourth which is kind of there, it's at least in terms of its brand name. So it's a pretty, pretty competitive market that's serving the needs of the Indian investor who is looking to save, invest and prosper. I think what you talk about stories is where the trigger for decisions by investors come from.
Right.
And therefore, unlike general news,
right,
where general news reacts to a development and then offers opinion and tries to create a sort of viewer sentiment around it,
right,
I am bound by what happens in the markets. We react to the live market. So if a company's earning has grown 20%, we want to be the first with that number because
so
that's,
you focus on the stories.
We focus on the stories, and policy is one of our strongest points. So I don't know if your data captures that, but anecdotally, I'm very happy to share the fact that in the entire insolvency and bankruptcy code, the NCLT cases where almost 8 lakh crore of bad debt has been sent for resolution to various courts across the country,
right,
BTVI has led that coverage. Huge, intensive,
wow,
minute-by-minute coverage.
Wow.
And that's what reflects.
And that's a topic of national interest, right?
Absolutely.
That's so important to know.
Absolutely. 1,25,000 crore is the current recovery. And more of it is going to happen as we go down the line.
Wow.
This is unprecedented, Pankaj. I mean, I've been a business journalist for 20 years plus.
Right.
I've never seen so much money being taken out of companies which are insolvent.
That is so interesting. I think you've got it bang on. Stories is what really matters for you. Moving on to the next important thing that the team here has figured out. When it comes to news, which is general news, Hindi, English plus regional, all forms of news, it's a huge market. There are hundreds of channels running today, right? What makes that difference is breaking news, right? That's what is news all about. Whereas the look and feel takes a back seat at 40% in terms of impact. Business news, on the contrary, is not driven solely by breaking news. The numbers are radically opposite. So it's a 60-40 for breaking versus look and feel on news.
60-40.
And it's a 40-60 on the other side, right? So
why
what matters is look and feel. One question, why is this? Two, are you investing a lot of money on the look and feel? Because that seems to make a difference.
Let me answer the first part of your question. Without you telling us your actual numbers, do you have a diversified financial portfolio?
I have a very limited portfolio, okay. Very struggling.
But all your money in one product? One
majority of my investments in real estate, but yeah, within equity, I've got a little bit of investment.
Multiple, right.
Yeah.
So the diversity of an ideal financial portfolio, a savings portfolio, is in some ways, and I'm trying to make this simple, reflected on the screen, a business channel screen, and I'm particularly proud of the fact that BTVI is the only product really where the look and feel has been done in-house. Wow. It is a Indian, it is a Swadeshi, it is a make in India kind of look.
Wow.
It's evolved over time. Wow. They have not imported a design sort of deck and supplanted it on
right.
Indian viewers.
Right.
It reflects the colors,
right.
The diversity,
right.
The difference
right.
And the diversity of India.
Right.
But why is there so much emphasis on look and feel? Because at any given point of time,
right.
There are 700 to 800 stocks that are
right.
important, that are moving.
Right.
There are data details like crude, international markets.
Right.
There are company earnings and results.
Right.
There are statements. There are tweets now.
Right.
So a business channel screen, pretty much all of the real estate is occupied. And there are times when we struggle that should we have 10 windows of talking heads
right.
or should we have 10 different data points.
Right.
Our preference is
right.
for data because that is what our
That's
viewer wants.
Absolutely right. But I would, again, having heard what you said, as far as ratings is concerned, there's a huge amount of research that goes into the kind of look and feel that will get a viewer who's flirting between channels to come and stick to one. We've seen channels having a lower third during a breaking news, which is practically flaming. Right? So that brings in the viewers. Do you guys invest in those kind of things?
I think
Not that I subscribe to it.
I think the business segment is far more serious.
It's far more evolved?
Yes.
Right.
And
they're smart enough to understand that flames really don't matter.
Yeah, yeah. And what really matters is speed of information,
right.
accuracy of information. Let me give you an example. If a company makes 1,000 crores of profit in a quarter, you can't have a decimal point moving left.
Right.
1,000 cannot become 100.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So accuracy is extremely significant.
Right.
And a third feature which is very, very important in business, and you know this as much as anyone else, is that most business television, and that is what market researchers tell me, is consumed on mute.
Wow.
In India.
Wow.
Unlike overseas.
Well, it's passive.
Yes. So
okay.
people are doing multitasking.
You're
looking at WhatsApp. You're looking at your handset based portfolio. You're looking tracking numbers. You look up at the screen, and therefore the screen needs to talk to you rather than it with its speakers on. And in institutions,
right.
There are multiple TVs
right.
that are on. So you can't have audio
right.
from all channels
right.
on at the same time.
Right.
And I think the look and feel aspect is significant from that point of view. And one last point,
right.
really. Unlike general news, where
right.
there are very compelling visuals of, for instance, a train tragedy.
Right.
Of an earthquake.
Right.
Or of a spectacular wedding of stars.
We've seen equally tragic views of the rupee falling.
Yeah.
And I had investments, international investments, so I saw those investments falling.
Yeah. So the compelling live visuals and footage that exist on general news
right.
are not always available
for business
channel producers.
That's right.
So they innovate. They do stuff around a coin falling to describe the rupee fall. But you cannot sort of trivialize it.
Right.
A currency depreciation works both ways.
Right.
And it is the result of multiple economic factors, global factors.
Right.
You cannot trivialize this.
Right.
And if you go way too much into sort of trying to do gimmicks around it, I know for a fact that viewers turn away because viewers believe that they come to you for serious advice.
Right.
For accurate information.
Right.
Which is without bias.
Right.
And in the cleanest, simplest way possible.
Brilliant. Thank you, Sid. I should congratulate you. One more fact. I've interacted with a lot of editors, but as an editor, your knowledge of the pulse of a viewer seems to be really intense. That
you,
goes on
you,
to say
you
that you guys
kind to
work
me.
Well with each other. Thank you for coming down,
Sid. Thank
it's
you.
Been a pleasure. Thank you.
Great time.